Hey, good morning, everybody. Nice and sunny here today in Melbourne, Australia. It's gonna be around 25, 26 degrees. Nice days for the beach. As always, I love going to the beach. And today I am planning to talk a little bit about the beans, corn, and pumpkin. I want to add some extra information that I have been looking on the internet, because I think it's very interesting the different aspects that you have to take in account when you plant these three plants together. So I want to give some valuable information today about that and explain what I'm gonna do today as per my daily routines, which is going to be just a light watering. So because it's sunny, so I'm just gonna put some water around. It hasn't rained for a few days, so I just want to make sure that plants are hydrated. Otherwise, everything is pretty normal, the same as always. And let's just have a look around. So here we have the beans, corn, and pumpkins. And they're growing nice and strong. Corn is looking good. It's very tall. It's my first year growing them. The only concern that I have is the pumpkins, which have not grown as much as I would like to, but I think the weather, it's been affecting the way that it grows, because it's been cold for the last few weeks. Except the last 5 days, it's been nice and sunny. So hopefully they can take off after this date in the summer space, in the summer time. So we are early summer at the moment, December 20th, and yeah, they're looking good. One of the things that I wanted to talk about was the way that you planted them. So I was looking at this website. It's called nativeseeds.org, and it's really interesting because they talk about how they have to be planted. So the crops of corn, beans, and squash are known as the three sisters. For centuries, these three crops have been the center of Native American agriculture and culinary traditions. It is for good reasons, as these three crops complement each other in the garden as well as nutritionally. So the corn provides tall stalks for the beans to climb so that they are not outcompeted by sprawling squash vines. Beans provide nitrogen to fertilize the soil while also establishing the tall corn during heavy winds. Beans are nitrogen fixers, meaning they host rhizobia on their roots that can take nitrogen, a much-needed plant nutrient, from the earth and convert it into forms that can be absorbed by plant roots. The large leaves of squash plants shade the ground, which helps retain soil moisture and prevents weeds. So they also talk about how they have to be planted. So first of all, let me have a quick look here. So first of all, the corn has to be planted first, so it can grow nice and tall. Then the beans, so the beans can start climbing up the corn, and then the squash come in, because the squash is gonna grow pretty long and it's gonna spread all around the ground. So that could be very beneficial, but also it could be damaging for the beans if the squash is planted first. So that's why first the corn, then the beans, and then the squash. So that's the mistake that I made this year, which I planted beans and corn first, so they together. Then I planted the squash. So I noticed that the corn was not growing as fast as the beans. So that's why next year I will be planting corn first, so it can grow taller than the beans, and the beans can eventually grow and it doesn't shade the corn. These beans are not climbing beans, so they are not gonna be going up the corn. But in this case, as I said, it's better to have the corn first, so it can grow as tall as it can first, and then the beans. So, let's do something else. Let's do the watering, and that's the end of my daily routine. It's not much to do here, which is good. I don't like to be busy all the time with the garden. I like to be here, but I also like to do other activities. So being in the garden don't have to take too long. I think what takes the longest for me is getting rid of weeds. Weeds can take over pretty quick. Sometimes it's hard work to remove them. So you have to be bending, you work on your legs, which is good. But also, if you are kind of like a lazy person, that could be a problem. But, you know, I enjoy it actually, and I'm not that lazy. I like my sports and I like to keep active. So for me, it's not too bad to be here in the garden doing some weeding. I would prefer not to do it, obviously, but it is what it is. So for today, it's just watering. I also come here and have a look what's happening around, what's growing, what I need to harvest. So here we got the tomatoes, different varieties. So these three, these four here are a variety, a type of variety. These other four here are another type, and these four here are another type. So I'm trying to grow them with only one stem going up. People usually grow two, three stems from one plant, but I am going to do just one. The main reason for that is because there is plenty of those plants in there, and they are gonna take over all this fence, all this frame that I have here. So only one, it's okay for me. Beautiful beetroots. So today is just light watering. I have an irrigation system that goes from here. So this is automatic. It's called Link Tap. Really useful. Works very well. Reliable. And it goes all the way here. And this spreads into four lines of dripping line. A thin one, very small. And goes 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then here is the same, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it goes all the way here. So this soil here don't need much watering. This is the one that I need to keep an eye on, just to see if the soil is dry. And also the rest of the plants around. So let's say this and the other pots that I have in there. And also the herbs, obviously. So I use mulch to keep the moisture in the ground, also to provide good nutrients, release nutrients into the soil and prevent weeds from growing. Mulch is very beneficial. I use sugarcane mulch. And finally here we have some watermelons. Some of them has died, so I replanted some of them. These two I started from pots, so I planted them in pots first and then I put them in the ground, which is, I think they enjoy more and they survive better when they are planted straight into the ground. So that's why I planted another backup in here and here, these two, which they are growing from the soil, from direct into the ground. So hopefully these ones won't die, but if they do, I have a backup here, so it's good to have backups. I planted this one a few weeks ago, now it's taking off. I think it's adapting to the soil better because I can see new growth on it. And that's the end of the watering here in the garden. I hope you found something useful today. I am new into the gardening space. Well, I started around 2-3 years ago, but I have enjoyed it a lot and I thought that it would be a good idea to start a channel and show what I do day to day. I'm still learning things and it's sometimes it's difficult to make the plants survive, but after a while I get to understand the patterns and see what works, what doesn't work, and then eventually I can grow stuff. So I feel accomplished and I feel I can do it. So that's why I show you all these things that I do, so you can have an idea and maybe hopefully one day you can start your garden and start planting your own food, which tastes delicious, and you can make lots of nice things for yourself, for the people that you live with, and have a healthy life. Anyway, if you enjoy the content of the channel, please don't forget to subscribe, give it a like, and have a nice day, everybody.